What's up, Capricorn? It's your girl Kelly coming straight at you for the Queen Tarot B in Boston. So, this is for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, Mercury, Mars, and Venus. If it's not your story this month, don't, or this month, I keep saying that, this week, for the week of January 14th through the 21st, 2020. I keep saying this month because I usually do monthlies. This week. If it's not your story this week, then don't try to make it fit, okay? I can read like nobody's business, but I can't read every single person. So it is a general reading and may apply to other people and not you. Cross watchers, welcome, welcome, welcome to the Queen Tarot B. You are always welcome here. Feel free to like, share, subscribe. That would be really appreciated. We're trying to spread the love. This is a beautiful community with a lot of beautiful people in it, and we get together on lives a couple times a month, and we just shoot the shit and have fun. So anyway, moving on. What I feel for you guys this month is there is somebody there who is still, I feel like before I did a reading, I don't know if it was last week or the week before, I can't remember. And I said, you have somebody leeching off of you. There's somebody who's a leech there. And the energy is very, very strong, very strong. Again, that this person is still around you. It looks like it's a cycle of, are you their bank account? They come back, they want money, or they want expensive things, or they want money and more money. And that's what they basically come around for. And I feel like it's just kind of like friends with benefits for money type of thing. There's a lot of lies and misconceptions. I feel like this person is very toxic for you. Extremely toxic to the point of obsession. And I don't say that very often. In fact, that might be the first time I've ever said it. I get a very creepy, yucky vibe, from this person that I can't keep quiet about. So just be really careful how you handle this individual. They seem a little bit off their rocker. Just saying, throwing it out there. Excuse me. Let's see what the cards have to say. I feel like you really need to pull away from this person, and if they continue, then get the authorities involved. This is going to be one of those. And I think you know it already. You're not really listening to your instinct. Bet you're wishing you didn't ignore those red flags now, huh? Yep, you really need to get away from this person, no doubt. If you look, we've got the card of the Hermit and then the Seven of Swords in the upright. So you've got somebody who's very, very, very sneaky here. And this individual, while you're inside yourself doing your own thing, I feel like this individual is off sneaking off somewhere else. No doubt in my mind, this person is going elsewhere and then coming back to you for whatever it is that they need. And it leaves you feeling in this shell. You feel like you're empty and in a shell. And you have no idea who to reach out to or what to do. This person is, it's definitely cyclical with them. They play the, it's like a little story. This is crazy. Okay, so you get the Knight of Pentacles who's walking away, right? Leaving this person devastated, okay? You can see that this is a cycle. This goes round and round. This happens frequently between these two. This is a person who will tell you whatever you want to hear to get whatever they want. And here is the Ace of Pentacles. What they want is the 3D goods, the material, expensive things. They want money. Money, 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 money. And they have you with your guard down. They caught you up with your guard down. And so you have these feelings for this person, but at the same time, it's like they're not really who they pretend to be. Look at the total opposites here. You've got the most beautiful card. And then if you look at the other one, the significant difference of her being tied up and bound and she's just, the Empress is so at peace with herself. Where this other card is tied up and bound. And so the front that this person puts on is one thing, but how they really feel is another. What they're really going through inside is a whole nother thing with this. They're not even able to see at all. Not awakened, not even close. Yeah, it's like right now you're just, you're closing your bank account off to this person. And you're realizing how unhappy you truly are with them. And you're just making that heavy-handed decision. That's it. I'm cutting you off. That's it. I'm done. I'm not doing this anymore. And it's showing you holding the bag tightly, just saying no. No. And you're looking right at the fact that you're extremely unhappy. And that this decision was really hard for you. You know, and this person just acts like they expect it. Like, entitled, like you owe them to give them money. It's like you're digging into your savings account. You owe them. Mm-mm. And now they're realizing that that's not going to continue anymore. And what you wish for, waiting for that, the seeds that you've sown to reap something, some sort of reward, something for it. And it's not coming in. That person is not reciprocating. You see that the Hanged Man and Temperance are both in the reverse, right? So we're talking about a situation that's in suspense. It's literally stopped. Okay, you're needing to gain knowledge from this situation. You're needing to learn how to put up a boundary and say fucking no. No. Because this person continues to come back, come back, come back. Money, 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 money. And you're just shoveling it on out. All out of balance. You need to pull back, take a break, and stop this whole cycle. And there's definitely some truths that need to come out here. No doubt about it. Ace of Swords. So you're taking on a new mental route. You're taking on a new mentality. You're taking on a new mentality, which is learning how to put up those boundaries and when to say no. There's the Ace of Swords. So new ideas, new boundaries, new mental boundaries. Taking a stand for yourself for once. Okay, guys, that's what I have for you for this week. Sorry, I had to re-record you because my other video had no sound, so this has been really fun doing all of my videos except for four over again. So I hope that you enjoyed it. Leave a comment below. Like, share, subscribe, do that whole thing, please. Trying to get this loving community out there so that other people can share in the happiness and the fun that we have. So, if you wouldn't mind. Anyway, it's your girl Kelly coming straight at you for the Queen's Arrow Bee in Boston, and I will catch you guys on the flip side. Bye, guys.